What basically motivated me to become an activist is I lived my life as a person who felt different, but I didn't have language to define who I was. So partly because I'm a transgender person, and because I was firsthand with what it means to be pushed out of that system, and having your identity stolen from you, and having your identity considered to be immoral and pathological, I felt I had to do something about this, and that was basically my entry into activism. We had a law in Uganda called the Anti-Homosexuality Act, which happened in 2014. And when this law happened, I was put in the red paper, which is a local tabloid in my country. And myself and several people had to leave the country. At the same point, there is an organization called UHAI EASHRI, which I work for right now. And UHAI EASHRI is an indigenous activist fund. And what it does is to resource LGBTI and sex worker movements in East Africa, in the 7 countries of Uganda, Kenya, Tanzania, Rwanda, Burundi, Ethiopia, and the DRC Congo right now. And I work there right now as a grants administrator. The first thing that we worked on was to see how to bring down this law that actually meant that I had to leave the country. That meant that my parents, my friends could be put in prison for being positive about my gender. And we supported activists in Uganda through a grant that brought down this act in 4 months. And for me, this was a huge victory. I also work in different arenas. I'm serving on boards of funds as an advisor. For example, the Australian Lesbian Fund that helps to fund work in East Africa. I also work to facilitate conversations for the new International Trans Fund. I still do face challenges as a transgender person in living in and navigating healthcare and access to social amenities in East Africa. But I can't really compare the challenges I'm going through to the challenges of the very many other transgender people who, one, have not had an access to education, so they can't access employment. They can't even think of accessing healthcare. They do not have options in terms of the labor market. This is harder for them. The thing I feel that needs to be done to be able to support the work of human rights defenders and myself is to have a more consultative process. A more consultative process where international organizations like the UN are able to let us know what mechanism do exist, and to either work with activists to interpret this into the activist realities and how this can be effective. So for allies out there, I would urge you to be cautious of the space you occupy in being able to support human rights defenders in terms of availing spaces for them to speak for themselves, but not allies to speak for themselves.